Hello students, welcome to the fourth session of C++ programming. Now we are going to discuss about the flow of control. In this session, we are discussing the selection statements. The first, the simple if statement, and second, the if else statement. In the next session, we will cover up the if else ladder and nested if. Before getting into the selection statements, first we need to know how the flow of control happens. The flow of control can be of three types. One, the sequential. Second, the selection. And third one, the iteration or looping. Sequential means statements are executed sequentially. That means one after the another. Then selection means based on a condition, a certain set of statements will be executed depending upon whether the condition is true or false. Then iteration means a certain set of statements is repeated multiple times depending on the condition. So three ways of executions are there. Now we already seen the sequential way of execution in the previous programs. Now we are starting the selection statements. First one, the simple if. The simple if first evaluates the expression, and if the expression is true, the given condition is true, then the course of action is followed. That means the statements will be executed. That means it first checks the expression, and if this expression is true, then it evaluates the body of if. Otherwise, if the expression is false, it is not evaluating the body and it skips those statements and come to the next statement after the if. So let's see the syntax, how we can write it as a program. You have to write the if keyword, if, small letter. Then after that, within the bracket, you can specify the expression. Then after this, within the curly bracket, curly braces, you can specify the true set of statements. True set of statements can be specified. If this statement, if you are specifying only one statement, this curly braces are not compulsory. You can avoid that. Then, one important point need to be remembered. Normally, we put semicolon after each statement. So, you may make a mistake. That means you may put a semicolon after this expression. So be careful about that. If you are putting a semicolon after this expression, then your if will end here. Then the statements after this if will not be the part of this if. So always remember this thing. Let's see some examples. Here ch is a variable holding characters. We have inputted the character, and within this if we are checking ch equal to dollar sign. So here using a relational operator, we are checking whether ch is equal to dollar sign. If this is true, then this message will be displayed. Otherwise, no message will be displayed. Then look at this second example. Here a, if a greater than 10, that is a relational operator operation. B less than 20, that is also another relational operator. So two relational operators joined by this AND sign, two AND sign, which represents the logical AND. Then if this expression, total expression, evaluates to 2, then this C equals A plus B and this display will be happening. Then look at the third example. Here you can see just a X here within the bracket. There is no relational operators used or logical operators used here. So how this evaluation happens? Always remember one thing. The zero represents false and non-zero represents true. So zero means false, non-zero means true. Positive is, suppose we are using a positive number or negative number, both evaluate to true. So depending on, suppose we are giving x the value 2. Then the expression evaluates to true. Suppose you are giving 0, then the expression evaluates to false. Now, if we are giving minus 7 for this x, then the expression evaluates to true. So, this is how the evaluation happens. And look at this second expression. If not, exclamation means not, logical not. Not x, that means just the opposite. Okay, if x is having a value 0, then it becomes true. Then if the x is having 2 means it is true. So just the opposite of true. The opposite of true is false. These logical operators and the relation operators we have covered up in the last videos. Just go through it if you have any doubts. Now let's see an example program which using the symbol if. The program is to display whether a number is negative. That means what is the logic behind checking negative? The number must be less than 0. Negative numbers means it will be less than 0. So we have given the aim, then we have included the header files, then within the main program we are writing the code for that. So here we have used a variable n here. The variable name is n, and asked the user to input a number, then we accepted that to n. Then look at the if statement. If I have small letter, then n less than 0, then we are displaying you entered a negative number. Here there is only one statement, so if you don't want, you can avoid the bracket. So I have entered the program. Let's see the program. And I entered minus 78 as the input. Minus 78. I got this message. You entered a negative number as the output. Now let's see another program, that is for checking whether a number is even or odd. How we can say whether a number is even? Divide that number by 2 and take the remainder. If the remainder is 0, definitely the number is even. So we have entered the aim, then the header files. Within the main program, we are writing the statements necessary. We declare the variable n. Here also I am using the same name n. Then asking the user to enter the number, then that is accepted to n, and we are checking whether the number is even. Even checking is done using this n modulus 2. What is the purpose of that modulus operator here? There percentage sign, it divide the n by 2 and takes the remainder. If the remainder is 0, the number is even. And how we can say whether a number is odd? Odd means divide that with 2 and the remainder is 1. So for checking that, I am using another if. So if remainder is 1, we are displaying the number is odd. That's all our program. Now let's run that using Turbo C. And in the first run, I am entering 86. And I got the message, the number is even. Then again I run the program and I entered 45 to the number, and I got the message, the number is odd. So we have seen the symbol if statement. And in the previous program, for checking even and odd, we have used two symbol if. We can avoid that if we are using if else. That we are covering up in the next video. So please go through it. Thank you.